This episode of Red River Reaper contains scenes of violence, coarse language, and scenes that some listeners may find disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Oh, are you finally awake? You know, I was going to wait a little longer before inviting you over for an intimate evening. But then you came strolling up to me like a lost lamb wandering into the wolf's den. And I just couldn't resist.
Where am I?
The train yard. Don't bother screaming. There's only one security guard, and he's a lazy asshole that stares at the monitors all night instead of patrolling.
You're the Red River Reaper.
That's what they call me this year. I've also been called the Cove Killer and Mountain Murderer. Honestly, Red River Reaper is my favorite so far. Has such a nice ring to it.
You're gonna kill me.
Oh, don't worry. You still have a few more hours before that happens. First, we're going to get to know one another. Inside and out.
Please, let me go.
Why do people always ask me this? Do you think it's going to work? That I'm going to magically change my mind and let you go? Please. Don't waste our precious time together with futile begging.
Why are you doing this?
Killing in general? Because it's fun. You can't possibly understand the thrill of knowing you hold someone else's life in your hands. To feel their last breath on your face as you squeeze the life out of them is glorious.
You're sick.
No! I'm just giving in to the urges that are within all of us.
You're the only one with the desire to kill here.
Now, Rosalind, don't lie to me. If I were to undo these chains, freeing you, you would try to end my life.
I wouldn't, because I'm not a sicko like you. I'd run.
And I would chase, I would catch you, and you would fight. You'd struggle beneath me, desperately searching for a weapon you could use to strike and kill me.
That's different.
Not so different. You'd feel no guilt because society deemed it acceptable to murder as long as you were defending yourself. You'd take my life and you would enjoy it. You would always remember the power you felt in that moment. Maybe even begin to crave it.
I wouldn't.
You can't know that for sure.
Is that what happened to you?
I see what you're doing here. Trying to get to know me so you can find some sort of weakness or way to convince me to let you go. It won't work.
That wasn't what I was doing.
Sure. All right. I'll play along. My first kill was in high school. There was a jock who made my life a living hell. He thought it would be funny to drag me out into the middle of the woods and leave me there all night, blindfolded and bound to a tree. When he was tying the ropes, I managed to knee him in the face. He flinched. It was only for a brief moment, but that was all I needed. I lurched forward, knocking him over, and before I even knew it, I was crushing his skull with a rock. His blood felt hot against my skin that winter eve. It was euphoric.
And what happened after that?
After? I buried his body, then walked home. What are you doing?
I'm not doing anything.
Nice try. Here I was trying to be kind by not making these metal cuffs too tight. And you betray my trust. How about we keep your hands where I can see them? And we will tighten these cuffs. This is on you, Rosalind. If you had behaved, then this would have been relatively painless for you. But now I'm annoyed and don't want to talk anymore.
Wait, please. I'll be good.
It's too late, Rosalind. You had your chance. Let's see. What should we start with today? Removal of fingernails? Pulling out some teeth?
Oh, God. Help! Someone! Please! Help!
I already told you not to scream. You are testing my patience, Rosalind.
Please, Dad. Please, let me go. I promise I won't tell anyone about this.
Oh, Rosie, how can you expect me to trust you when you have already broken my trust twice?
I won't tell anyone who you are. I swear it.
How about this? I will let you go after I gouge out your eyes, cut out your tongue, burst your eardrums, and chop off your hands and feet. Does that sound agreeable?
This isn't real. This can't be happening.
All right. How about we get those clothes off so I can take a look at my canvas?
No. No. Please, please don't.
Relax. I have some compassion, Rosalind. Scissors. Where are the... Ah! Here they are. You really are beautiful, Rosalind. Such smooth skin.
Don't touch me.
Do you know why this is my favorite kill spot, Rosalind?
No.
It's my favorite spot because there are so many interesting things just lying about for me to use on you. I have really grown fond of railroad spikes. They impale flesh and bones so easily. Shall I show you?
No! No! Please, no!
Since you were so keen to use those hands of yours, why don't we render them useless?
No, 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 no!
Brace yourself. This is going to hurt a lot. Come on, Rosie, don't you pass out on me. We are just getting started.
Rosalind, are you home? Rose?
The number you have dialed cannot be completed at this time. Please hang up and try again later.
That's weird. Rosalind, where are you?
Stacy here.
Hey, Stacy, it's Marcus.
I know, sweetie. I do have a call display.
Right. Listen, have you heard from Rosalind today?
Today? No?
I can't get through to her phone. It says her number's unavailable.
Really? That's odd. Let me try. Hang on.
Come on, Rosalind. Where are you?
Marcus?
Yeah.
You're right. Wouldn't connect.
When was the last time you heard from her?
A few nights ago. She called me after your fight. I'm assuming you two haven't talked since then.
She told you about that?
Yeah, of course. Who else was she gonna talk to about it?
Did she say anything about going out after work?
Nope. She was pretty distressed. Could only think about you and how bad she hurt you.
I'm gonna call her work.
Okay, let me know if you manage to get a hold of her.
Yeah.
You know, Rosalind, I really do like you. You're an intelligent woman. Kind. probably too kind since you ended up in this situation. Maybe I should just make this quick. Would you like that?
Go.
Go? Go where?
Go. Fuck yourself.
Language, Rosalind. What? Who could that be?
Help!
If you scream again, I will kill your friends at work, and then I'll find out where you live and slowly skin your precious Marcus alive. Fuck. Are you going to scream and be the reason why your friends die?
No.
Stay quiet.
Hello? Is someone in there?
Damn it, Garrett.
This area is off limits. Rosalind? Hang on, I'll get you out of there.
Behind you!
Huh? Damn!
Why the hell did you come here, you dimwit? Fuck! The security guard is going to see your car and come over here, you know? You've ruined everything, Garrett. He's dead.
You're a monster.
Do you think I wanted to do that? That's not how I kill. I got no joy out of that. And now I need to figure out how I'm going to make this work. I can't dump his body in the river. The moment the police find him, suspicion will be cast in my direction. Think, Dan, think! That's it. Garrett, buddy! You are going to disappear, and the Red River Reaper killings will end with Rosalind. I'll have to find a new location to work and dump bodies. But starting over is always exciting.
How can you do this? He was your friend.
Here's the thing about people, Rosie. We are all replaceable. The CCE will hire a new conductor. We will become friends, and Garrett will be forgotten. Even you, Rosalind. You will die, and your darling Marcus will move on. He will fall in love with someone else, and it will be as though you had never existed.
That's not true.
It is. If you truly believe it's not, then you're more naive than I thought.
Marcus loves me. He might move on, true. But he would never forget me.
Oh, Rosie. Sweet, sweet Rosie Posey. I never said he'd forget you. Hell, no one will forget about you, Rosalind. You're going to be famous. The last victim of the Red River Reaper. They are going to make documentaries about you. They will study you in schools. We are going to be immortal.
Oh, I should thank you. Should I weep at your feet and sing your praises, you insane fuck?
Now, Rosalind, I don't appreciate facetiousness. Nor do we have time for this. As much as I would love to spend more time together, I now have an uninvited guest to attend to. So I suppose this is farewell.
Wait, no! I was here!
What are you talking about?
I was here when you walked in and saved me from Garrett. The Red River Reaver. I can support your story.
That's honestly not a bad idea. Unfortunately, I don't trust you. I just know that one day you're going to break my heart.
No!
Did you really think I'd kill you with a railroad spike? Please. Though the police are incompetent, they would eventually figure out the murder weapon. No, sweet Rosie. I always cut the throat of my victims at the river bend. Less cleaning to do. Well, ready to go?
No!
I gotta get back here quickly to clean up Garrett's mess.
Fuck you!
Come on. Your legs work just fine. Get up and move it.
You want me to move? Make me.
I'm getting angry, Rosalind. I have done nothing to deserve your ire, so I would appreciate it if you would cooperate here, because you really don't want to make an enemy of me. Now, move!
How many?
How many what?
How many women have you killed?
You'll be my 17th kill. But I don't just kill women. You see, the problem with most serial killers is they are creatures of habit. They have a type. They kill the same way. Eventually, they get complacent in their routine, and that leads to mistakes. But me? I'm an experimenter. I enjoy reinventing myself, trying new things. That way, things never get boring and I don't make mistakes.
You made a mistake tonight.
I did not.
You left my legs mobile.
You can't run from me, Rosalind. No matter where you go, I'm going to find you. I can hear you.
Fuck, 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 fuck.
I told you this would happen. You ran, I chased. And look at you now, looking for a rock to hit me with. There, to your right. Pick it up. Hit me! Kill me! Make your choice, Rosalind! See? I told you you'd strike. You're going to have to hit me a lot harder than that to kill me, though.
I wasn't trying to kill you.
And that is your mistake of the evening.
Hey!
Who are you?
Marcus! Marcus, are you real? Are you here?
I'm here. I'm here.
How did you find me?
The water samples the police took from the bodies. There was diesel oil inside of it. Looking at what was along the river, this was the most obvious location for the killer to be dumping the bodies. And when you weren't at home, I knew something was wrong. I know, baby. I know. Come on. Let's get you to the hospital.
We have to call the police.
I already did. They're on...
Marcus! Marcus!
There's nowhere to go, Rosalind.
Marcus!
He's dead, you bitch! Just like you're about to be. Get back here! Fuck! You let her get away! You fucking piece of shit! This is all your fault! Fuck you, Marcus! Fuck you! I'll get you, Rosalind. No one ever escapes.
It's clear.
Blood is still warm.
Wait, isn't this the conductor from the other day? Gareth?
Garrett, I believe. And yeah, it is.
So we're looking for the engineer.
Dennis, over there. There's a phone.
That's odd. It's not even password protected.
I didn't think phones allowed you to do that anymore.
Well, look at this model. It's ancient. I'm still surprised it works.
Anything useful?
There's three voicemails.
Play them.
Hey, Dan. It's me, Gare Bear.
Yo, have you left work already? I forgot my non-work lucky hat there, and I was hoping you could possibly grab it and bring it back to your place, because game starts in about an hour, and I really need my hat, because I'm, like I've told you already, anytime they lose, it's when I don't have my hat. And, you know, anytime I've lost it before, I've always been looking around for it, and then my wings are in the oven, and then they're overdone, and the smoke alarm starts going off, and I gotta air out my... God, sorry, I know I'm garbage at leaving you messages. Yeah, so, totally cool if you didn't grab it. I can just stop by the train yard later and grab it myself. I hope I can make it back, because I still gotta feed Oscar, as well as get my wings in the oven and kind of, you know, kind of get the juju flowing before the game actually starts. And, you know, always got to be on the sofa in the right spot. Okay. 3 for 3. We'll make it like this. I've got my message across. So, love you. Bye. Wait, love you. God. Idiot.
Oof, poor bastard. Should have just waited till the morning.
Look. The Schuber app. There's an address from last night.
All right. Let's call this in, then head over there.
What about Marcus? He said he was coming out here, but there's no sign of him.
You're right. I'll go take a look around. You call in the scene and get a team up here. We need to sweep every inch of this room.
Yeah. Wait. Be careful, yeah?
Killer's probably long gone. Security guard probably scared him off.
Yeah.
Marcus! Marcus Wagner? Marcus, are you around? Who's there? Show yourself! Marcus! Marcus, if that's you, this isn't funny. Freeze!
How does it feel?
How does what feel?
How does it feel to know that you're about to die?
I'm the one with the gun here.
Do you know what I hate about guns? They take away all the fun. You shoot, and that's it. It's a coward's weapon. Probably why you pigs love them so much, huh? Unfortunately, I have a woman to find and no time to deal with you cops. So gun it is. I do hope you'll forgive me.
Karen!
Sleep well now.
Shit! Karen! Karen, hang on! Officer down! I repeat, officer down! Need medical assistance immediately! Hang in there, Karen. Hang in there.
I hate guns. What the fuck is it now? Rosalind! Now this is a surprise. What are you doing in my house?
You killed Marcus.
Yes, and Garrett, and that lady detective. I've had a rather busy night. So what is it that I can do for you?
I'm here to kill you.
Oh, really?
You killed Marcus.
So you've already told me. I was there. I remember. So, tell me, sweet Rosie, how do you plan on killing me?
I thought I might choke the life out of you. See what all that fucking nonsense was you were spouting off about power and breaths on cheeks.
That's my girl, finally giving in to the desires within! I'm actually rather proud of you.
I'm not your girl.
You're in no condition to be fighting, Rosalind.
Neither are you. Not so fun when you're the one who's in pain, is it?
Oh, I don't know. This is still kind of fun. Actually, I don't think I've ever had so much fun.
I hate you.
Damn, Rosalind. I think I'm in love with you. After all I did, you couldn't do it.
I'm not a monster like you.
So, what now?
You go to prison for a very long, long time.
If it's all the same to you, I'd rather just leave town.
You have to pay for your crime.
See, that's where we disagree. So I'm afraid I'm going to have to kill you after all.
The police are probably on their way.
Then I'll make this quick.
Hope you enjoyed your book, you psycho. Sorry, Dan. Looks like your fun is over.
It's been 2 weeks since Detective Parker captured the Red River Reaper, and he has finally agreed to sit down with me for an exclusive interview. We will discuss the events leading up to the Reaper's arrest, and of course, talk about the tragic passing of his partner, Detective Karen Turling. But first, let's watch a clip from the interview from the woman who managed to avoid the Reaper's glaive, Rosalind Williams. Rosalind, first of all, please accept my deepest condolences for the loss of your longtime boyfriend, Marcus Wagner. I cannot even begin to imagine what this entire situation must have been like for you.
It was, well, difficult would be an understatement. Hell, Stacy. It was hell. It still is. Marcus is gone, and nothing I can do will change that. I keep wishing. I'm sorry.
Hey, no. Don't you dare apologize. Do you need a moment?
No. Let's continue before I change my mind about this.
Tell us, truthfully, how are you?
I feel like I'm broken beyond repair. But someone once told me that I had gotten so caught up in the responsibilities of living that I had forgotten how to live. I didn't really understand what she meant by that until that night when the Reaper took me. Only through facing death was I able to understand what it truly meant to be alive. And I certainly am not going to waste any more
of my time. Are you watching that video again? Hun, you gotta let it go. Move on.
It's only been a few weeks, Stacy. I will move on, but I need a little more time.
Well, I should thank you for that interview. It's not every day my videos go viral.
Well, you might be happy about that, but I can't go anywhere without people asking me weird questions.
People are just curious about you.
Speaking of curious, how are things going between you and Detective Parker?
Well, really, well. I know we've only been dating for a week, but I have a good feeling about him.
I'm happy for you, Stace. I really am.
What about you? Any plans to get back into the dating scene?
No, it's way too soon. I think I might actually go on a vacation.
Really? You know, I hear Scotland is beautiful this time of year.
How soon can we leave?
I'll have my bags packed tonight.
Good evening, and thank you for choosing the City Center Express. This is your conductor, Brett, speaking. Doors are now closing, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride.
All right, Rosalind. A lot of viewers want to know how you feel about the Reaper being incarcerated. Many are saying they would rather see him dead. What are your thoughts on this?
Honestly, Stacy, I hope he lives for a long time. I want him to live in a 6x8 box with nothing to do. Let him live each day just simply going through the motions. No way to indulge in desire, no hope of getting out. I want him to spend the rest of his days thinking about the one who got away. The one who took his power. The one who held his life in their hands and had the strength to let go. A shadow. Starring the voices of Jenna Oliver as Rosalind Williams,
Luca Xavier as Dan Smith,
Key Garland as Stacy Cameron,
Maxadrian Burton as Marcus Wagner,
Gerald Hill as Detective Dennis Parker,
Melissa J. Lackie as Detective Karen Turling,
Roscoe Braman as Garrett Graves,
Emily Evans as Vanessa Burns,
Nelson Abrego as Passenger,
Avia as News Anchor,
Justin Saint as reporter.
Rachel Onding as newscaster.
Michael Ignacio Jr. as cafe and bookstore customers.
Sean Kedzier as Schubert driver.
Jackie Gorton as phone operator. Ed Haynes as...
Conductor Brett here!
Written by Jenna Oliver. Script edited by Carrie Murphy and Roscoe Braman. Wayward theme written, composed, and performed by Key Garland. With music by David Obanihi. Hi, this is Jenna from Wolf Magpie Media. We hope you enjoyed Red River Reaper. Next week, on Monday, November 28th, we will be posting a full-length version of this audio drama, so you don't have to listen to it in episodic form for all you bingers out there. If you liked Red River Reaper, please consider donating to our Ko-fi account, ko-fi.com/wolfmagpiemedia. If you can't donate at this time, that is perfectly okay. Just give us a like, share, comment, positive review. Everything helps. We are already in the stages of development for our next entry into the Full Moon Mischief Anthology. We hope you'll come back and listen to our not-so-merry Christmas story. Thank you again for listening/watching. Be sure to check out our social media for little bonus clips and behind-the-scenes stuff. You can find us on Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram under Wolf Magpie Media.